Princeton. Thank you very much. Good evening. When I first met Dr. Lotta in the 70s through a one-hour interview I did for Radio-Canada, she was deeply focused on her task in international development and not too keen on delving into the past. So for many years, we shared interest in her development projects abroad, especially in Nepal. But as much as Lotta did not dwell on the past, part of her remained firmly anchored in a period of time from which she derived her profound sense of duty. The service uniform she wore all her life was the direct expression of her solidarity with the victims of World War II and a pledge to serve fully the orphans and the destitute. I was aware that Lotta had escaped from the war zone, and I had read the details in Clyde Sanger's very good biography. But it was only after her death that some of the particular aspects came into focus for me. In 1990, I had inherited a few of her books signed Lotta Hitschman, her Jewish name, that I found again in an exhibition at the U.S. Holocaust Museum in Washington. Lotta Hitschman's name was among a lengthy list of luminaries such as Marc Chagall, Hannah Arendt, Heinrich Mann, and Marcel Duchamp, who were identified in the 40s as intellectuals in absolute need of visas for the US by a young Harvard professor named Varian Fry, now considered the American Schindler. Just last year, as I was revisiting the barracks in the extermination camp at Auschwitz, where I have been working as an artist for the past 15 years, I was struck to the core. In the suitcase room, where hundreds of cases are loosely piled up, I suddenly paid attention to the first suitcase at the very left of the display in the showcase. In standard white lettering, used on all the suitcases, the name appearing is that of Lotta's mother, Els Hitschman, Sokolska 36, Prague 2, the address of the family home given in her biography. Now, when I walk the fields of the concentration camp and see the ashes still coming out of the earth, one more person has a name. Beyond her personal tragedy and through the USC that is her monument to life, Dr. Lotta has given an identity and a future to thousands of children. At age 25, I took one of her many special cases, a boy of 15, who went on to become the first orphan from the Balmandir homes in Nepal to obtain a university degree and major scholarships in the US. And now his own son has also obtained these major scholarships in the US in physics. Undoubtedly inspired by Dr. Lotta's sense of duty, Javi, our son, returned to Nepal to serve the government as a civil servant of absolute integrity. Having been a refugee sponsored by the United Nations High Commission, I encountered myself and Dr. Lotta, the best of what can come out of the dark hole, a compassionate soul, free from the dividing claims of nationality, race, or religion, working to build a new conscience rooted in progress and in shared humanity. And this is the legacy that we are